Welcome to today's webinar. This is about Magicblast, our next-gen sequence aligner. Before we start, there's a few preliminary things on this slide that are probably of use to you. If there are questions and answers to those questions, we'll make them available after the webinar. They'll be linked to our webinars page. They will also be in the materials directory on the FTP site. Okay, so today's webinar is going to talk a little bit about Magicblast, which is NCBI's next-gen read alignment program. And as I said previously, I'm Peter Cooper. I'm from the NCBI Customer Services Division. And with me today are Tao Tao, who's also from Customer Services, and he's part of the Blast support team. And also, special guest, Greg Boratin is here. He's a Blast developer who is responsible for Magicblast and who wrote the code. So he'll be available to answer some technical questions about that if we have any about the particular subject. So here's what we're going to cover today, the next 20 minutes or so. You're going to learn about what Magicblast is, what you can use it for. We're going to describe some important features, advantages over other similar programs. You'll also see some typical ways to run it and where you can download it. So after we go through the slides, I'm going to switch to a terminal window and a web browser and do a quick live demonstration of using Magicblast on the command line. And hopefully that will all go well. What is Magicblast exactly? Magicblast is a Blast-based short read or next generation sequence aligner. It works with output formats from lots of different next gen alignment platforms, RNA-seq and DNA-seq from the common ones. It aligns next gen runs to a reference genome assembly or to a transcriptome. It also incorporates ideas from John and Danielle Thury-Meek's AceView pipeline, which is used here at NCBI. These give faster extensions and better accuracy at splice sites and edges of alignments. So, as I said, Magicblast can work with RNA-seq and DNA-seq. It can align RNA-seq to a genome reference or to a transcript reference. There are lots of things you can use this kind of application for, SNP discovery, and that's the thing we're going to do today when we look at a Ebola virus genome. You can use it for genome annotation. That can include things like gene discovery or splice variant discovery and confirmation. You can use it for expression analysis or for analysis of metagenomic samples. So a number of important features of Magicblast are things like the fact that it's able to take input reads as in a number of formats, including the ability to just give it an SRA accession and have it access that accession at the NCBI sequence read archive, so you don't have to even download those, and I'll talk more about that in a second. It's one of the chief advantages of Magicblast. The reference genome or transcriptome can be given as a FASTA file or as a BLAST database. And when you download the Magicblast package, you get the BLAST program, Magicblast DB, with it, so you can, if you have a FASTA file, you can make a BLAST database very quickly. It will automatically decompress GZ files and read them, either the read or the reference or both. It produces splice alignments for RNA-seq to eukaryotic genome assemblies. That's sort of the default operational mode of Magicblast. It works with paired reads, and it provides combined scores for paired reads. It outputs the sort of universal standard SAM output or a special tab-delimited output that's got some useful features for parsing. So what are the major advantages of Magicblast? Why would you use this compared to some other next-gen aligners? One is, and I think this is probably one of the most important ones, is that it can work directly with NCBI SRA accessions. That's the SRA option in Magicblast. So that means you don't have to download these locally. You can just access them through the command line. The other thing that you can do is you can use a BLAST database for the reference. This is faster than and creates a smaller index than many of the other next-gen aligners. Magicblast appears to be, at least in some experiments that Greg has done, better at identifying real introns, ones that really exist in the messenger RNAs. And unlike many other short-read aligners, Magicblast returns all alignments to the reference genome, as well as the alternative loci. And as you probably know, NCBI has created 200 or so alternative loci for regions of the human genome. And so you want to be able to align your reads to those as well as the backbone sequence. So Magicblast has a number of command line options, and it shares a lot in common with the BLAST programs. And like the BLAST programs, BLASTN or BLASTP, you can simply type the name of the program, -help, to get a list of the options. This just shows you the top. There's a long list, and it describes them in some detail. So that's one way that you can use this to find out what options are available. And like I said, many of those are the same ones that you might be used to from using standalone BLAST. So these are usage examples that are taken directly from the README file on the FTP site. So you can look at that for a little bit more detail. But there's a number of ways that you can use MagicBlast, and here's some typical ones. The first and most simple way to use it is with FASTA files, where you have a FASTA file as a query and a FASTA file as a subject. And those of you who are familiar with standalone BLAST, this is basically the same kind of command line that you would use for BLAST2 sequences. The other way you can do it is to use a BLAST database, and that's one of the things we're going to do today. We're going to make a BLAST database out of a genome sequence where your query can be the reads, and we're actually going to expand that option a little bit. And instead of downloading the reads first, we're going to do this option where we're going to use the SRA option to get the SRA accession from the NCBI SRA site and then align that to the virus genome. As I mentioned, MagicBlast is aware of paired reads, and so when you're working with paired reads, you should use the paired option to make sure the MagicBlast knows the reads are paired. When you're working with transcripts, there's some different options. By default, MagicBlast will make splice alignments, and you want to turn that option off if you're working with transcript sequences, or if you're working like we will be today with a virus or a prokaryotic genome. There's also the ability to use this dash ref type transcriptome that will sort of automatically include a bunch of options that optimizes the program for working with transcripts. And like with the BLAST programs, the output format option dash out format gives you a number of options here, the main one being SAM, which is the default. And if you want to work with SAM, of course, you're going to use the SAM tools, which is available from that htslive.org site or from the SourceForge. And you need to install that, and it will manipulate SAM files for you. And we'll use that today to make an indexed SAM file, and we'll load that up into our graphical sequence viewer to show us a way of discovering some SNPs and some Ebola virus reads. The tabular output format is there as well, and if you want to see a description of what columns are available in that output, take a look at the README on the FTP site. And it also generates the sort of standard NCBI output format, which is ASN.1. So where can you get MagicBlast? You can download it. It's available in the BLAST executables area of our FTP site. There are compile programs there for your basic normal kinds of operating systems, Windows, Macs, and Linux. And if you like, the C++ sources are there as well if you want to try to compile that yourself. Okay, so I want to, before we begin the example, I just want to show you where I got this example. And basically, I shamelessly stole it from one of the NCBI hackathon projects. As you know, we have a number of these hackathons throughout the year. This is one that is a program called Sidearm, or really a pipeline called Sidearm, that is a way of analyzing SRA data for the presence of viruses. And I'm going to credit Paul Cantalupo at the University of Pittsburgh, who is a leader of the group that developed this pipeline. And so we're going to use a real simple example from that that's just one read against one virus genome to show you how this all works together. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to get a patient Ebola virus sample read from the SRA, and that's the run accession number there, and we're going to align that to the Ebola virus reference genome. We're going to use the MagicBlast to make that alignment. We'll get a SAM file out, and I'm going to manipulate the SAM file with SAM tools to get a indexed BAM file, and then I'm going to upload that onto the graphical sequence viewer of the Ebola virus reference genome. Okay, so what I want to do now is leave this and go to the web browser. So I'll start here, and we'll take a look, first of all, at experiment in SRA. This is a Zaire Ebola virus genome sequencing from the 2014 outbreak in Sierra Leone. And this is a isolate from a single patient. It's a fairly small run with only 33,110 spots. And that's why it's easy to do this in a real short demo. And if I look at the run, I can look at the reads here, and I can see that this has paired reads. So I want to keep that in mind when I do the alignment. The thing that I want to align this to is the Ebola virus genome. By the way, this particular file that I'm showing you right now is the in the on the FTP site in the directory for this webinar. So the other thing I want to just get up for everybody right now is the graphical view of the reference genome, and we're going to come back to that in a little while and upload our alignments that we're going to make. And so this is the reference genome of the Ebola virus. And we're going to add a track to this in just a few minutes. So one of the first things I could do from here, if I wanted to have this as my reference genome, is I could easily download this. I could send it to a file. I could download it. And what I want to have this is in FASTA format. So I could go ahead and create this file. And I've already done that, so I won't bore you with that download, although this would just take seconds to download. So what I'm going to do now is go over to our terminal window and run some commands to do some things with this. So I'm on a directory that's on a server here at NCBI. And I made a little backup directory here in case things go wrong, which they sometimes do. So, but I do have that FASTA file that's available there if you want to see it. So this is that Ebola virus complete genome. So that's going to be my reference. Now I'm going to go ahead and do some commands to go ahead and make this alignment. Let me go back over here and I'm going to keep my window open here. Really don't want to type in front of you because I'm terrible at typing for one thing. But here's a typical command line that you could use to format this FASTA file as a database. And so that's the first thing I'm going to do. And so the command line simply tells me what my input file is, what kind of database type this is. I'm going to use the option parse seq IDs. And I called the database just the base accession number of that genome. And if I see now, I can see all the files that are part of the BLAST database in there now. So the next thing I want to do is to go ahead and align this. And first thing I'm going to do is just show you the output that you get when you get a SAM output. And it's actually going to spill on the screen, but that's okay because we're going to put this in a file in a moment. So notice that I use the option splice F, and I also used so that to tell it not to do spliced alignments, and I also am telling it that these are paired reads. And so what you're seeing now that's going to be dumped on the screen is the SAM format. And just don't get dizzy as it goes zooming on by. We won't spend any time today sort of analyzing what the SAM format is, but I just want you to see that you can run this one fairly quickly. Once it gets done scrolling, it'll be finished in just a second or two. So that's not terribly useful to just see that dump. We could dump that into a file if we want to. But the main thing we want to do here is to try to make this into some kind of useful format. By the way, if you want to, you can see what the tabular output looks like by adding the tabular option here. And I'll just pipe that into more so that we don't have to watch it scroll by so terribly long. So you can see the headers of the columns that are available for the tabular output there. And the tabular output is useful because it keeps the paired reads together. And then as the last step of making things with the alignment, I'll go ahead and create a sorted BAM file. And this is basically invoking SAM tools, so I'm basically going to pipe the output into SAM tools to get that to work. Let's see how fast this is. If it takes too long, I'll go ahead and get the one that I have in the backup directory. One of the things that I forgot to do is to make sure that the SAM tools was in my path. That was one of the things that I meant to do before I got in here. So I could add that if I want to. But as a matter of fact, since it's going to take a minute to run that, I'm going to go ahead and show you what that output, show you that we do have that output. The other output that I wanted to do is to make an index BAM, and that is easily seen how to do that here. So you could run that command too if you wanted to. Let me go ahead and just clean up this mess. And I'll go ahead and change into the backup directory because I've already made these things. So the files are in here. Here is the SAM file that I could create if I want to. The BAM file and the sorted BAM file is right here. So let's go ahead and, the index for the BAM file is here. Let's go ahead and load that. So I can do that by going to the tracks menu here, go to custom data, and I can select BAM files. So notice that it wants me to upload the BAM file as well as the index file. Go ahead and upload those. And I'll configure that. And so you see that's now at a new track at the bottom. Let me get rid of some of these tracks that we're not going to be interested in here. And you can see this kind of mountainscape there of the gray and red. And the reds are basically places where there are mismatches between the reads and the reference genome. I'll go ahead and zoom into a particular region here. We can begin to pick out the landscape of changes here and the alignments of the reads themselves. I could actually go in and zoom to the sequence if I want to. And then I can investigate changes in some of the codons here in the coding region. Some of these are silent substitutions, many of them are. And so this is basically using Magicblast as a way of visualizing SNPs, and you could use it in a way of actually identifying and counting SNPs if you want to. Okay, so I'll finish up the talk with just a list of useful links, including the link to the SAM tool site where you can download SAM tools and put them in your path so that they work for you. NCBI Hackathons has a webpage available. You can go there to look at the hackathons, and you can find the one that we talked about today. Reminder that we have a YouTube channel. The Learn page is a way you can get access to lots of our documentation and help documents. Fact sheets on the FTP site is another good resource for help documents. If you have any questions about anything about NCBI, you can write to the help desk through the BLAST help or the NCBI help desk. If you have a question about the webinars, write to webinars, webinars@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov. I think Tao has been pretty busy over there with Greg, so do we have any questions, Tao, that you think are worth addressing? Okay, so most of those questions have been addressed through the questions pod. We'll make them available in the document that's going to be uploaded on the FTP site. Okay, so in the questions that are going to be available on the FTP site, there's some questions about how does this compare to Bowtie and other aligners, and Greg addressed that. There are questions about benchmarks for performance and sensitivity, and there's also a question about the publication, and there is an upcoming publication for this. And the rest of these are pretty straightforward, and you can find the answers to those questions in the online documentation. Okay, Tao has suggested I address this question. Is the source code of the graphical sequence viewer available for local installation? The answer to that question is yes, in principle. You can set it up and embed it in your own web pages, and there are instructions for doing that on the graphical sequence viewer page. We can put that in the documentation. So the question is about, do you have to download an SRA file to run the alignment locally by command line, or can we run it on the NCBI server? The alignment won't be run on the NCBI server. You can get the SRA file from the NCBI server, but the alignment's going to be performed locally. There's no way to run this as like remote blast. So, okay, so the question about whether steps are auditable, apparently we won't provide that. I'm going to go ahead and end the webinar now. Thanks very much for coming.